Hi Capricorn, this is Tracy from Northeast Tarot, and welcome to your weekly tarot forecast for the week of November 13th through the 19th. This is for Capricorn Sun, Capricorn Moon, and Capricorn Rising signs. So Capricorn, for this reading, I'm using the Hanson Roberts Tarot deck along with the Goddess Guidance Oracle cards by Doreen Virtue. Okay, very interesting. All right, and at the bottom of the deck, okay, I have the Five of Swords. All right, so with the Five of Swords, because I see that travel is so significant here in this spread, Capricorn, for some of you could be moving away from a challenging time in your life with the Five of Swords. Maybe you experienced some conflicts, some arguments, some deception. Maybe some of you could have felt defeated, or, you know, just dealing with a lot of challenges, maybe a lot of challenging people or energies. But I see so much travel here in this spread. Some of you could be definitely moving on from that time, that energy, moving forward with your life. I do see a nice progression here. You have the Five of Swords at the bottom of the deck, which can be energy. That's with you when I'm filming this reading. And then we do have the Six of Swords here in the spread, which is coming up for this upcoming weekly forecast. So that is a nice progression with the Six of Swords. It's moving on from challenges. You know, sixes represent balance and harmony, and you just feeling a lot lighter, and things are, you know, feeling a lot easier. But the overall energy is the Page of Swords, which can represent news or communication coming through, news that's very significant. For some of you, it could have been news that was delayed, but now it's coming through, because I definitely see communication coming in for many of you that this week. Communication, news is significant. Maybe it's news that is allowing for you to maybe move forward in some way, or this could be even a decision, information that's coming in that's allowing for you to maybe move on with your life, or maybe even physically travel in some way. Because again, travel is so significant here. Now, the Page of Swords can also be for a very small number of you, because it's a general reading. For me, he's someone who's a little on guard. He's very vigilant. He's on the lookout. You know, he can be someone who's expecting the worst. So, you know, if you're a Capricorn that's feeling like that, or maybe, you know, you're fearing the worst, you feel as though this news isn't going to come through, or you could be experiencing delays, you really definitely need to stay positive. Because I see news coming in, and I definitely see travel in the cards for many of you. Now, you're starting out with the Ace of Rods. You actually have a couple of aces here in this spread. The Ace of Rods is an exciting new beginning. It could be something you're very passionate about. It could be a new adventure, a creative project, a new home, a new relationship. We have the Ace of Rods with the Chariot, which the Chariot for me is an empowering energy. This is you very much in the driver's seat, and you're steering this Chariot exactly where you want to go. So some of you are moving towards this Ace of Rods, this new beginning. And I think that for some of you, this Ace of Rods definitely could be on the relationship front. So there could be some Capricorns, you're getting into a new relationship with the Ten of Cups and then the Ace of Rods. This can speak about that physical attraction. This could be that spark that's taking place, that physical chemistry. But with the Ten of Cups here, I think it's showing potential, you know, to maybe grow into something much more with the Ten of Cups, that emotional and spiritual bond. So I think that those of you that are getting into a relationship, it actually has a lot of potential here. And that could be why we have the Page of Swords here for some of you. Maybe you're a little on guard. You're not sure. You're on the fence. You're just like, yeah, I really don't know, because there is this maybe strong physical attraction, but maybe, you know, maybe you haven't really gotten to know this person just yet emotionally. So you're like maybe a little unsure here, but, you know, again, just stay positive. With the Ace of Rods and then the Ace of Pentacles here, this is a solid new beginning. And if it is a relationship, excuse me, if it is a relationship here, if this is the same new beginning, this can be representing that spark, that passion, that excitement. But also when the Ace of Pentacles does come up for me and it's on the relationship front, it's talking about, again, a relationship that has a lot of potential, especially sitting with the Ten of Cups here. You know, this could be potentially, you know, maybe one day someone you're going to have a family with, or someone you're going to marry, or maybe be together with this person for many years. So again, it's showing that potential. And then for other Capricorns, you know, you could be moving house with a Chariot here and the Ace of Pentacles. Some of you definitely could be moving house. You and your family could be moving house. This is exciting for you. For other Capricorns, you know, maybe you're starting a new job here. You could be starting your own business, but you also might be moving house. Maybe you have a couple of, you know, new beginnings that are starting for you here this week. You have a couple empowering energies, so that's really good. With the Chariot, you're in the driver's seat. It's also a card of victory. This is like the ultimate victory card. So again, some of you could have went through some challenges previously, but you're going to come out on top. But the Chariot is an empowered energy, and also the Emperor here is an empowered energy. So some of you are definitely in the driver's seat. You're definitely in control. You're empowered. Some of you are making this happen. And it could be due to you hearing something, or maybe news that was delayed is now coming in with the Knight of Rods and then the Emperor here. You definitely could be traveling. Maybe some of you have to travel for work, or you are moving house. If the Emperor is a character, this could be your boss that's communicating with you. Most likely this person is a fire sign person. Could be an Aries, could be a Leo, could be a Sag. But this could be your boss that's communicating for some of you, letting you know you got the promotion, or you landed that new job. Maybe some of you have to travel for work this week. But I think it's making you happy. I definitely don't see you having a problem with it. And you know, with the Five of Swords, in the more positive sense with the Five of Swords can be a more aggressive approach, someone who will do whatever they have to do to be successful. So maybe some of you, when it comes to, you know, some of these new beginnings here, and what it is that you're manifesting, maybe some of you have had to take on a more aggressive approach when it comes to this. If that's the case, you know, I see that paying off for you, definitely. The Knight of Rods is someone who's enthusiastic. You know, he's got a ton of energy. I just think that some of you, you have this new beginning that you're beginning, and it's really exciting for you. This is like a new adventure. It's an exciting time for you. And, you know, with the Six of Swords here again, you know, I see you moving away from feeling challenged. This is you moving towards, you know, just feeling a lot lighter. Some of you could be mentally moving on from a difficult situation, and you're moving directly towards, we have the Sun. So, I mean, the Sun is another card of success. Success, happiness. This is like the ultimate happiness card. You truly feeling content. This is a healing energy. So if you're a Capricorn that had maybe some health issues going on, this is you maybe definitely seeing an increase in your energy levels here. It definitely could be healing, just feeling just a tremendous amount of happiness here. For some of you, your children or a child could be significant. You could be spending more time with your child or your children. There could be some Capricorns that you're actually going to be going on vacation. Maybe some of you are going on a family vacation. Or, you know, if you're older and your children, maybe they live down south, or they live in a warmer climate, you could be traveling to see your children or traveling to a warmer climate. But however you resonate with this Capricorn, these are some amazing energies here. This is by far a wonderful spread, the best spread that I've seen so far for this week's forecast. So we see success, we see new beginnings, we see a lot of just happiness. Your cups are runneth over definitely this week. We also see you very empowered, travels definitely in the cards. New beginnings definitely taking place for you. So this is a wonderful, wonderful spread. Let's pull you an additional guidance card, Capricorn. Additional guidance for Capricorn. What else does Capricorn need to know? There we go. Sorceress. Okay, you are a magical person who can manifest your clear intentions into reality. Excuse me. There you go. This is a great card, the Sorceress card. You are a magical person. You can manifest your clear intentions into reality, which we definitely see you doing this week, Capricorn. You're empowered. You're in the driver's seat. You know, set those intentions and just go for it. You're definitely manifesting. So this is wonderful. Okay, Capricorn, so I hope that you found this reading helpful. If you are not subscribed to my channel, please do subscribe. And if you are interested in receiving a private reading, please check out northeasttarot.com. I wish you a wonderful week.